first thing we are going to understand is structural isomerism, and first part to write down chain isomerism in a structure. Two or more isomers, definition of chain isomer, you write down. Two or more isomers which has different number of carbon atom, which has different number of carbon atom in the parent chain, different number of carbon atom in the parent chain are said to be chain isomers of each other. Two or more isomers which has different number of carbon atom present in the parent chain are said to be chain isomers of each other. Okay, molecular formula must be same. That is the condition we have, right? Yeah. We can define isomers with same molecular formula. Okay, for example, you see, if I write down N pentane is what? CH3, CH2, 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 CH3. If I write down this compound, CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CH3. CH3, CH, CH3, CH3 and CH3. Can you tell me the IUPAC name of this one? This is normal pentane, N-pentane. IUPAC name of this one? 2-methylbutane. Right? How many carbon atoms are there in the parent chain? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many carbon atoms are here? How many carbon atoms are here? Okay, this is 2-methylbutane. And this is 2,2 dimethyl propane or neopentane. Please see, all these three compounds, the number of carbon atom in the parent chain is different. What is the molecular formula for this one? C5H12. The molecular formula of this one?
Get the base.
So you have to have like L and
N. All these should be there.
L should be the worst.
Only the automatic. But not the
last pair. So see, all these molecules have same molecular formula, but their structure is different. Structural formula is different. One has 5 carbon in the parent chain, 4 and 3. All these are chain isomers of each other. We can say 1 and 2 are chain isomers, 2 and 3 are chain isomers, 1 and 3 are chain isomers, right? All these are chain isomers of each other. Why? Because they have different number of carbon atom in the parent chain. Okay. Similarly, butane and isobutane also chain isomers of each other. Number of carbon atom in the parent chain, 1, 2 and 3. Here we have 1, 2, 3 and 4. Right? So that if the number of carbon atom in the parent chain is different, with same molecular formula, the molecules are said to be chain isomers of each other. Got it? Next, write down positional isomers. Positional isomers. Two or more isomers which has different position of functional group, or locants or multiple bonds. Different position of functional group or locates or multiple bonds are said to be positional isomers of each other. Okay, one note you write down. Next. Are said to be positional isomers of each other. One note you write down. In all positional isomers, the number of carbon atom in the parent chain must be same. In all positional isomers, the number of carbon atom in the parent chain must be same. What is the name of this compound? Butanol. This one? Butane two all, right? So what is the difference here? The position of functional group is at first carbon. Here we have at second carbon. Number of carbon atom in the parent chain is 4. Number of carbon atom in the parent chain is 4, right? So we have 4 carbon atom, butane 1 all, butane 2 all. The position of functional group is different. These two are positional isomers of each other, right? See this example. These two are positional isomers of each other. Butene and butanin, double bond, the position is different, right? Locates the position, you can see here. If you write down chlorine at this carbon and chlorine at this carbon. These two are also positional isomers of each other. 1,1 dichloro, 1,2 cyclohex, right? Positional isomers. What about this one? They are not isomers, because molecular formula itself is not, right? But when you place this CH3 here, then these are some positional isomers. Okay? So all these are positional isomers. Number of carbon atoms in the parent chain must be same. One more point to write down here. The monovalent functional group, write down monovalent functional group like COOH, carboxylic acid. Monovalent functional group like COOH, nitrite, CN, aldehyde, acid halide does not show positional isomerism. Does not show positional isomerism. Why is that so? Monovalent functional group like carboxylic acid, nitrile, aldehyde, acid halide.
Anything that includes the CN itself.
No, in all these functional groups, we always start numbering from the carbon atom of the functional group. So these functional groups will always get first position. Position will always be the first. That position won't change. That's why they don't show positional isomers. What about this two compound you see? What kind of isomers we have? Suppose we have CH3, CH2, CH2. CN, CH3, CH, CH3, CN. Huh? What kind of isomers? Chain isomers? What is the name of this compound?
No, the same number
compound. The carbon and cyanide don't count.
The CN you don't count, right?
CN and C you don't count.
We count in the, when polyfunctional group, then we don't count. Monofunctional. Butane nitrile it is. First question here. Nitrile, if it is there, we are bound to start the numbering from this carbon atom. So here also we have to start from this carbon atom. That's why you see the position is not possible, because the position of the functional group is what? Is always 1. Right? But the number of carbon atom in the principal chain is what? Different? So these are what? These are chain isomers. If the number of carbon atom in the parent chain is different, then that won't be the positional isomer. Similarly, this example you see. What about this one? What is the name of the second one?
This has the chain and it's
2 carboxylic acid.
No, why would it's carboxylic acid, methanoic acid,
1,2 methyl, right?
the
propellant.
Yeah,
yes, one,
oh, yeah,
function will count in the parent chain.
Oh, so that's what
this
is one when you say,
you know, when you say it's a carboxylic, two carboxylic acids,
that's why it's more than one.
Condition kuch aur hai. So normally, if you don't listen to me carefully, that condition is if the COOH present on the ring.
Oh yeah,
सब होगा फिर. Nomenclature is all about rules. Rules नहीं याद रहेंगे तो फिर नहीं होगा. ठीक है? तो इसको तो we have to count in the parent chain, right? We have to start numbering from this carbon. 1, 2, 3. So propanoic acid. Second position we have methyl. So 2-methyl propanoic acid. What about this one? 1, 2, 3. Butanoic acid. So obviously the number of carbon atoms in the parent chain is different. Can't be position isomers. So these two are chain isomers. All these functional groups you see, we are bound to give first position to this functional group, hence they won't show positional isomers.
So what about two COOH groups on a ring?
So dicarboxylic group, right?
So but then you'll have to specify, right?
1, 2.
No sir, what if it's 5 ring?
5 membrane. Position to the numbering you have to do accordingly so that you'll get the least possible.
So but then you can get different numbers for their different positions, right? Like what if they're two carbons apart or only one carbon apart or on the same carbon?
No. You see, what we are talking about when this carboxylic acid is, we are talking about acyclic compound. Ring to hum log consider kar hi lete hain. That's why ring will consider in ring chain isomers. Uske liye we have one different criteria. Okay.
So but here we consider the CL ring.
Where? Now in this one is fine. You see here, if you write down COOH here, right, or COOH here, ऐसा कुछ होगा. Yeah, if you can write down this one. These two are positional isomers of each other. Why? Because this is not present in the parent chain. Parent chain तो वही है देखो. Six member ring. Parent chain तो वही है. ठीक है. Parent chain में अगर वो होगा तो वी हैव टू गिव फर्स्ट पोजीशन टू दिस कार्बन एटम. इसलिए वो तो हो ही नहीं सकता है पोजीशन आइसोमर्स के लिए. हियर आल्सो सिंस द पेरेंट चेन इज 6 5 मेंबर कार्बन एटम दैट्स व्हाई इट इज पोजीशन आइसोमर. बट इन दिस थिंग वी हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस कार्बन एटम. वी हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस कार्बन एटम दे वांट टू पोजीशन आइसोमर. ठीक है.
नो सर बट Sir,
so
I thought you said that COOH can never form a positional isomer, but
that,
here it is.
No, that means if COOH, this carbon atom, if you consider in the parent chain, and that we have to do if it is acyclic,
yes.
Not cyclic. Correct?
Study was too easy.
Okay, third type you write down functional isomers. Functional isomers. Two or more isomers. Which has different functional group are called functional isomers. Okay, for example, alcohol and ether. We'll write down the example of alcohol and ether. Alcohol and ether can show functional isomerism. Example is ethanol and dimethyl ether. The first one that you took, CH3CH2OH and CH3OCH3. Alcohol and ether, functional isomers. Okay. Again, you write down alcohol and phenol. Alcohol and phenol, functional isomers of each other. Alcohol, you see, it is, we have a ring, CH2OH, this compound, and OH here, CH3. What is the name of this compound?
So that's
The first one.
It's one phenyl methanol. Yeah, one phenyl.
Because this is the functional group attached with it. So this becomes the parent chain. Right? And this is substituents phenyl and this is methanol. So one phenyl or simply phenyl methanol it is. Okay? This one is methyl phenol. Right? Methyl phenol. You see the molecular formula is same. This one is the derivative of alkyl derivative of phenol, and this one is the what we can say alcohol, right? OH on the ring is phenol. OH with alkyl group is alcohol, right? So this is alcohol. This is phenol. Derivative of phenol can show functional isomers of each other. Functional isomerism.
So how do we name the second one?
It is methyl phenol. Or we can say 1, 2, 3, 4 methyl phenol. Paramethyl phenol also you can say. Okay? But ortho para we don't write in IUPAC numbers. Aldehyde and ketone, for example, you see CH3, CH2, C double bond OH. Aldehyde and ketone, CH3, C double bond O, CH3. Again, functional isomers. Functional group is different. Write down, amines are also functional isomers of each other. Amines, CH3, CH2. CH2, NH2. Don't get on this. It is 1 degree amine. Right? RNH2. What about this one? CH3, CH2. NCH3, H. It is 1 degree or primary amine. It is 2 degree or secondary amine. You can check the molecular formula is same. Or if I write CH3, NCH3, CH3, tertiary amine. All these three compounds are functional isomers of each other. Okay? So primary, secondary and tertiary amines are functional isomers of each other. Got it?